गुड मॉर्निंग। सो टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू स्टडी रिगार्डिंग द प्लानिंग एंड कलेक्टिंग द डेटा फॉर रिसर्च एंड डेटा एनालिसिस एंड इंटरप्रिटेशन। सो लेट्स बिगिन विद द चैप्टर। सो कलेक्टिंग द डेटा इज इम्पॉर्टेंट पार्ट वंस वी हैव डिसाइडेड द डिजाइन। सो इन डीलिंग विद एनी रियल लाइफ प्रॉब्लम इट इज ऑफन फाउंड दैट डेटा एट हैंड आर इनएडिक्वेट। ओके, so and hence it becomes necessary to collect data that are appropriate. So if we have a data which is appropriate, then the conclusion interpretation would be proper. So the data collection plays an important role in the research. So there are several ways of collecting the appropriate data which differ considerably in context of money cost, time, and other sources included energy at the disposal of the researcher. So collecting appropriate data is must whenever you are going for a research, but it includes cost you have to spend on it. It includes the consumption of the time and other resources too. So primary data can be collected either through experiments or through survey. If it is a scientific method, then it will become an experiment. And if it is a survey and it is a social research, then it will become a survey method. The researcher conducts an experiment and he observes some quantitative measurements or the data with the help of which he examines the truth contained in his hypothesis. So once we have set the hypothesis, to check hypothesis, we require a particular data which will determine whether the set hypothesis are working or not. Okay, the result will be we are going to get it or not. That plays an important role. So in case of survey, data can be collected by any one or more of the following ways. The first is the observation method. Last classes we have already seen how observation exactly works. And this is the collection of information by investigators' own observation. You are looking into some respondents and you interview them. The main information obtained relates to what is currently happening and is not complicated by either the past behavior or future intentions or attitude of respondents. So it's whole and soul, it's all about the observation made by the interviewer or the investigator who is interviewing the respondents. This method is no doubt an expensive method because you have to go personally. It's a time consuming and meeting personally and huge time is spent and huge energy is spent on this particular method. And the information provided by this method is also very limited one. So as such, this method is not suitable in inquiries where large samples are concerned. If the research is belongs to very few members, then the observation method can be used. Next is through personal interview. So here the investigator follows a rigid procedure. He will be having questions with him and seeks answer to a set of preconceived questions through personal interviews. You've already seen how this has been done and the questions will be asking to you continuously step by step and you have to answer for it. And with that, you will be evaluated. So this method collecting data is usually carried out in a structured way where output depends upon the ability of the interviewer to a large extent, because how the interviewer is getting the information from the respondent, that plays an important role. So whole and soul here, it depends on the interviewer. Next is telephonic interview. You also get this some of the time. Some of the service providers will ask you through telephonic interview. So this method of collecting information involves contacting the respondents on telephone itself. So this is not very widely used method, but it plays an important role in industrial survey in developed regions. So particularly when the survey has to accomplish in very limited time. And here in telephonic, you have to ask very minimum questions, very limited questions. So with that, you can go for telephone interview because no one is ready to spend a huge time on telephone. And next is by mailing of questionnaires. So this is the digital method directly mailed to the respondents through which you can calculate the data. So here the researchers and the respondents do come in contact with each other. If this method of survey is adopted, questionnaire mailed to the respondent with a request to return after completing the same, either in the form of a digital or in the form of a hard copy. The both can be used here. So it is the most extensively used method in various economic and business survey. So there will be a set of boxes where you have to fill it and you have to send it back if it is in hard copy. And if it's a way of digital mode, then you have to just tick it and submit it. Before applying this method, usually a pilot study for testing the questionnaire is conducted, which reveals the weaknesses, if any, of the questionnaire are there. So questionnaire to be used must be prepared very carefully so that it may prove to be effective in collecting the relevant information. So that plays an important role. So pilot study has to be made before going for the main study. So then you can go with the milling questionnaire. Next is through schedules. So in this method, the enumerators are appointed and given training for it. So they are provided with schedules containing relevant questions. So these enumerators go to respondent with these schedules. There will be a particular slots will be given and they will be coming and asking the questions in those particular set. And here the training will be provided to the enumerators who are going to ask questions or do the survey with the respondents. So data are collected by filling up the schedules by enumerators on the basis of replies given by respondents. So much depends upon the capability of enumerator so far as this method is concerned. So here the enumerator plays an important role. The training depends on it and what is the ability of that enumerator is. So some occasional field checks on the work of enumerator may ensure sincere work. You might have seen some of the example like this is like you might have seen the head and shoulder and shaving kits and some of ladies equipments and soap. The ladies comes and they will ask us how do you feel. Most of the time you might have gone through this. So those people are trained, they will giving a sample and they have to reply back after a certain period of time. So the researcher should select one of these methods of collecting the data, taking into consideration the nature of investigation. And the total depends on the investigator or a researcher who is going, and he has to choose the best method which will suit him. So here objective and scope of the inquiry, financial resources, available time, and the desired degree of accuracy matters a lot. So he should pay attention to all these factors, but much depends upon the ability and experience of the researchers. If he is a new researcher, then he has to take in advices from the guide or the experience or colleagues. If he's experienced, then he will be very good at what type of data has to be collected. So in this context, Dr. A.L. Bowley very aptly remarks that in collection of statistical data, common sense is the chief requisite and experience the chief teacher. So the Dr. A.L. Bowley rightly said that collection of statistical data, common sense is chief requisite. Not only in this, for every aspect, the common sense plays an important role. What to be asked and what methods to be used and how it is going to be done. And experience the chief teacher matters a lot. We can call him as a guide. So they plays an important role in this particular selecting the collection of the data. And next is the analysis of the data. So here, after the data have been collected, the researcher turns the task of analyzing them. Okay, so once the data collected, so we use different method of analyzing statistical techniques and tools. So analyzed data requires a number of closely related operations. So such as establishment of categories, the application of these categories to raw data through coding, tabulation, and then drawing statistical inferences. So especially the SPSS tools and Excel tools are used for the data analyzing. Okay, and the unwieldy data should necessarily be condensed into a few manageable groups and tables for further analysis. So the The main reason of analyzing data is all depends what results have come out. Okay, so those researchers should classify the raw data into some purposeful and usable categories. That plays an important role. A coding operation is usually done at this stage, through which the category of data are transformed into symbols that may be tabulated and counted. So tabulation is all about setting up your old data in the tabulated form. And editing is the procedure that improves the quality of the data for coding purpose. So with coding, the stage is ready for the tabulation. So once the coding is done, then tabulation is a part of technical procedure. So wherein the classified data are put in the forms of tables. You have already seen this, how this tables works and how the data has been kept in the quantitative technique study in the last semester. The mechanical device can be used of in this juncture. A great deal of data, especially the large inquiries, is tabulated by computers. The computers not only save time, but also make it possible to study large number of variables affecting a problem simultaneously. So if you are doing a research for 1,000 or even 5,000, so how you are going to evaluate, that will be the biggest question arises. So with the technological development, we can use these technologies where within a couple of minutes of time, you will get whole data which is analyzed. So that will save time also, and which will encourage you also. Analysis work after tabulation is generally based on the computation of various percentages you do. This much percentage of the people says this is very effective. This many percentage says not effective. Then you study regarding coefficient, then other tools, by applying various well-defined statistical formulas. So in the process of analysis, the relationship or differences supporting or conflicting with original or new hypothesis should be subjected to test significance to determine with what validate data can be said to indicate any conclusions. So you have already studied how to calculate the hypothesis and what is the method and significance level and all this you study, a region and all. And with according to that, the analysis is done through the data collected. For instance, if there are two samples of weekly wages, each sample being drawn from factories in different parts of the same city. Okay, so giving two different mean values, then our problem may be whether the two mean value are significantly different or the difference is just a matter of chance. So this you have already studied in your hypothesis calculation of last semester, and how we set the significant level and the differences. So through the use of statistical test, we can establish whether such a difference is a real one or is the result of random fluctuations. So this is analyzing part. And if the difference happens to be real, the inference will be that the two samples come from different universes, that is the population we say. And if the differences is due to the chance, the conclusion would be that two samples belong to the same universe, means both are same population. So it will become a comparative study, or it will depends on the universe also. So similarly, the technique of analysis of variance can help us in analyzing whether three or more varieties of seeds grown on certain field yield significantly different results or not. So this is regarding the scientific method. So you have a different seeds with you, varieties, we can say, and same land is used for the production. So what will be the production of different seed will be given, whether all are going to give the same result or different results. So variance can be found out with this type of research. So in brief, the researchers can analyze the collected data with the help of various statistical measures. Next comes the generalization and interpretation part. So here, if hypothesis is tested and upheld several times, it may be possible for the research to arrive at a generalization. So that is to build a theory, okay? Or we can say even we can build a model also. As a matter of fact, the real value of research lies in the ability to arrive at certain generalizations procedure by the researcher. So the researcher had no hypothesis to start with. He might seek to explain his findings on the basis of some theory, okay, which has already been done. So it is known as interpretation. The process of interpretation may quite often trigger off the new questions, which in turn may lead to the further researches. So anything which is lacking in this, that will become a gap, and that will add to the new research. New researcher can go for it, which is untapped. So this is regarding today's class. If you have any questions, you can ask.